Hello.
Welcome to a new video. Today we want to look at transcutaneous pacer therapy with the corpuls3. In addition to bradycardic arrhythmias, the corpuls3 also offers us the option of treating tachycardic arrhythmias with the help of a pacer. For the exact indications, please refer to your local specifications or the guidelines. To carry out pacer therapy, we use the core patch electrodes. To ensure that these adhere optimally to the patient's chest, I not only have to undress the patient completely, but also dry them off or remove chest hair if required. If I want to use demand mode, I have to prepare a monitoring ECG first. But I think we should actually take a look at this in practice.
We have already prepared the patient with a monitoring ECG. In this case, we positioned the electrodes on the torso to reduce any possible movement artifacts. Verena, would you please get out the therapy electrodes? We have opted for the adhesive anterior-posterior variant. Here, as a reference, we can orient ourselves on the lower third of the sternum at the level of the fifth intercostal space, slightly offset to the left. To position the rear electrode, we first have to gain access to the patient's back. One option here is to lay the patient on their side, or, as we've decided to do here, sit the patient upright. So, Verena, will you take over, please? The lower edge of the shoulder blade to the left of the spine serves as a reference point for the rear electrode. Here we adhere the electrode flat and make sure that no air bubbles are created. In addition to the anterior-posterior method of adhesion, all other common adhesion methods are, of course, permitted.
Now we will show you how to carry out pacer therapy. To do this, we open the relevant menu by pressing the pacer function key. We are shown the information about the recommended electrode placement again. Since we have already done that, we can confirm it. And now we are in the pacer menu. On the left of the display, you can see that we are in demand mode. This is the mode in which the device starts automatically and in which we will now demonstrate the further procedure. If I want to change the mode, I can do that by pressing the corresponding soft key here in the middle. On the right side, you can see the preset frequency. It's currently set at 70 per minute, which works for us, so I'll leave it as is. To change the intensity, I select the intensity soft key. And I can adjust it using the jog dial. As soon as I do this, the device will automatically start the therapy. You can see here at the top that we now have the pacer spikes marked with a diamond. Whether we start from the top or from the bottom is locally variable. Please refer to your own standards. We will start from the bottom now. We slowly increase until we can observe capture. And that would be the case now. An electrical capture is not always the same as a mechanical capture. To check that, I still have to palpate the patient's pulse. Ideally, this should be done at the radial or brachial pulse, or in the groin, not at the carotids. You can also add a safety buffer on top of this. I would now choose 10 milliamps here. This is also regionally variable.
We are now in an ongoing pacer therapy. Should it happen that an ECG electrode becomes detached that is responsible for ECG lead 2, the stimulation will be interrupted first. A technical alarm will occur, and we will be asked whether we want to switch to the fixed mode. If we solve the issue and reposition the ECG electrode within 10 seconds, the therapy will automatically continue in demand mode. Outside this time window, we must first confirm and then actively resume the stimulation. To interrupt the pacer therapy, you can press the pause soft key here. A safety prompt will appear. Yes, I want to. Now the therapy is paused. To resume it, simply press resume again. And the safety prompt appears. Yes. Now the therapy will continue with the preset values.
During the ongoing pacer therapy, you also have the option to switch to monitor mode at any time. To do this, simply press the pacer or monitor button again. The therapy will continue without interruption. We have now shown you pacer therapy in demand mode as a quick and very simple way to treat bradycardic arrhythmias. We hope you could take away something. As always, any wishes, questions or suggestions go in the comments. Otherwise, feel free to press the bell so you don't miss anything or leave a like. Cheers. See you next time.
Ciao.